Until recently, most New Yorkers took transportation access for granted. But what the recent failures of the transportation system in the city have shown is just a small window into what our clients who have disabilities face. The accessoride system fails hundreds of thousands of New Yorkers on a daily basis, denying them the independence and dignity that all the rest of us enjoy.
AAR is accessoride, and it's the paratransit service that's in New York that's supposed to be comparable to the buses and trains that folks use every day. And you have to go through a whole process to sign up for it, to get approved for it. People think that you can get it for free, and you cannot. $2.75 each person, each way.
I became disabled late in life. I was shocked to see how people were treated by the government, by the MTA. Accessoride is plagued by terrible problems. They have awful on-time performance. Is a car going to show up?
In the disability community, there's a very low percentage of people that are employed. But there's many disabled people that have a college degree, that have the power and the will to go and work. But then the question is, how do I get to work?
Why should I be in a position where I'm potentially going to lose my job because I can't get there on time? One time I was on Accessoride for 5.5 hours. I have been in every borough multiple times. Even if I wasn't going to that borough, I've had cars break down.
If I have to get to a doctor's appointment at 9 o'clock in the morning, I'd have to wake up 2 hours earlier and be out of my house 2 hours earlier. So that's 4 hours out of my day already. I'm forced to schedule it when I could just be going out right now, doing what I have to do. I can't do that when it comes time to accessoride.
New York Lawyers for the Public Interest reached out to partners in the community, and we formed the Accessoride Reform Group. That coalition has been very active at all levels in the organizing department, in the training department, in the individual advocacy department, in advocacy with elected officials, advocacy with the city and the state.
The end goal of this campaign is really for the first time to have equality and parity for New Yorkers with disabilities in terms of having 24-hour-a-day access to quick, efficient, effective, and safe transit.
Right when our coalition got off the ground, the fare that Accessoride users had to pay was going to be increased. We came out in force and said, this is not going to be tolerated. We are not balancing any budget on the back of people with disabilities. And we were very successful in getting the governor and the mayor to change their minds.
You know what it is to go out every month to the MTA board meetings with people supporting the same issues? It was time for them to open their eyes and say, okay, let's pay attention, and they are.
We're really excited that following the launch of AARRG and demonstrations by AARRG members, the MTA reached out, said they were ready to launch for the first time a pilot on-demand paratransit service system.
The pilot program consists of 200 people who either use the app on their smartphones or they call directly to book an on-demand trip. We are a big part of that. We pushed for it. This is something that we wanted, and we came together as a group.
I remember the first day it started, and I was like, oh my God, where can I go? Where should I go? I now have the freedom to do whatever I want to do when I want to do it. And that wasn't available to people before.
Moving forward, we plan to look at the systematic changes that are going to happen with the pilot program and survey those who are taking it to see what they feel needs to be done.
It is getting reformed. They are listening to us. They know who we are now, and they've paid attention. But it's the work that we've done in art that's made this happen. And we're going to have a better life.
The measure of a decent society is how it treats its most vulnerable citizens and provides them with the services they need to thrive and to participate and to grow.
Anyone at any time can join the disability club. If someone asked me 4 years ago if I'd be an amputee, I would have said no. It's not something that's separate from everyone. It's not something that's, oh, just you people. No, it's all of us.
New York Lawyers for the Public Interest is unique in its ability both to be out in the communities that need its help and need our help, and then to network with their member law firms and in-house corporate legal departments to deliver the legal services, the advocacy, the organizing that needs to get done.
Over this last year, we've been able, across all of the program areas, health justice, environmental justice, and disability justice, to mobilize against threats that we see.
We were feeling that the atmosphere was changing within our branch libraries. Some of our immigrant patrons were feeling more nervous about coming in. They weren't sure if the library was a safe space. The first thought I had was I should call New York Lawyers for the Public Interest. The guide put out by New York Lawyers for the Public Interest has enabled our librarians and our staff to give accurate information to our patrons, which is the most important thing we have in being a librarian.
NYLPI came in and leveraged our resources. People are able to literally get one step closer to citizenship. They understand the community. It wouldn't make sense to have a naturalization application assistance project if there weren't green card holders eligible to naturalize.
La dueña nos quería desalojar sin darnos tantas explicaciones. Nos dijeron que nos teníamos que ir porque si no, que iba a llegar inmigración, que nos iban a sacar y que iba a ser un peligro después para nuestros hijos. Y nos dio miedo en realidad porque a cómo está ahorita en este país, han estado ahí también buscando la solución para ayudarnos, para que no se quedara eso así.
NYLPI's come to Job Pass Assistant twice. Both were circumstances where people with disabilities were losing their homes, primarily because they were people with disabilities. NYLPI was there with us all the way, and now Robert's got a home for the rest of his life.
It definitely makes the community stronger by banding together and seeing what their rights and needs and wants are.
NYLPI came in and helped us by having the transit station held accountable for their actions, for the things that they have not done. And because of that, we will have a better community.
We've been working with NYLPI, with our patients who are undocumented, to obtain active coverage to help them obtain health care and medical services that they do require. We are their last hope. You're able to make a difference.
We are working to ensure that DACA recipients continue to have the Medicaid coverage that they have currently, despite the program ending. And when you're able to give people back the control that they can have over their own health, definitely facilitates their empowerment. It facilitates so much positivity in their lives.
The urgency of our work has rarely been more clear. We are proud of our partnerships with our communities and also the private bar. NYLPI will always be there to respond to new threats and needs, but also lay the groundwork for true lived equality for all New Yorkers.